knows a lot about all kinds of stuff. Professor Dave Explains.
If we are going to learn Latin, just as with any other language, we need to learn the basic sounds of the language first. This may seem like it would be difficult or arbitrary for a language that people don't speak anymore, since we don't have any audio recordings from ancient Rome, and in fact, there have been endless arguments about how to read certain vowels. These arguments outline the differences between the ecclesiastical pronunciation and what is believed to be the classical pronunciation, which we can essentially describe as arguments between Italian scholars and German or British scholars. In this series, the pronunciations we will be using are the best approximation to the original language that we can achieve today. But we should be aware that some sounds might be presented slightly differently by the speakers of different languages. Regardless, we will certainly want to avoid unrefined mistakes, such as pronouncing the letter I as we do in English. To begin, Latin has long and short vowels, even though they were not marked until after the classical period. The long vowels are marked with a symbol above the vowel called a macron. Unlike English, where a long vowel will sound quite different from a short vowel, in Latin, the difference between a long and a short vowel has to do with the quantity of that syllable rather than the sound. Syllables in Latin are long or short by nature or by position. What's important to remember is that technically, but almost undetectably, a long vowel would take twice the amount of time to be pronounced as the short vowel. This was a particularly important detail for poetry, where verses were metrically composed and accompanied by music. But it does not matter so much for prose. However, there is more to discuss. Soon we will learn that long vowels in Latin have important grammatical implications. For example, the word puella with a short a would describe the subject in the sentence, while the same word puella with a long a would be translated as an ablative case, as in cum puella, which means with the girl. But we will get to such specifics soon enough. Let's start by going over the most important phonetic rules. For this, we will be following the classical Latin rules of pronunciation, and not Church Latin, which is closer to the rules of the Italian language. The consonants, which we will get to a bit later, were pronounced pretty much like in English, with a few modifications. But let's start with the vowels. Latin has five vowels, and these could be pronounced differently depending on how they are accented. Let's go through each version of each vowel with a phonetic reference in English, as well as some specific examples in Latin. A, as in ago, casa, ad, mensa. A, as in father, carus, gratus, fabula. E, as in bed, sed, luceo, eris. E, as in they, cana, spero, me. I, as in is, and never pronounced I, milia, noxius, gallicus. E, as in machine, never as in milk. Ic, gallina, insula. O, as in often, mora, novus, locus. O, as in o, moeo, negotium, pono. O, as in look, never like the French U, German U, or English bus. Sum, puer, ut. U, as in root, tu. Duco, murus. Y, this is technically non-existent in Latin, but was brought from ancient Greek, and it is pronounced like E. Lira, syllaba. Moving on, we must also learn about diphthongs. These are combinations of vowels in one syllable. They are pronounced fluidly one after the other and not in sound combination like in English. Let's check out the most common ones. Caesar, Aek, Saepe, Aurum, Laudo, Out, Deinde, Europa, Pleuritis, Euripides, Poena, Proelium, Cui, Uic. So that covers the basics regarding how to pronounce vowels in Latin. Vowels are very important when it comes to phonetics, but we must also learn about consonant sounds. So let's move forward and do that next.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.